You know what this town could use? You know what Baltimore could really use? Another one-way street.
That's the way I see it.
I don't know how you people get around. I went out for milk today. I ended up in Philadelphia. I don't know. Well, give me a hoagie cheese shake. I saw a guy today with, like, weird hair. He carved a line going all the ways around his head. Just this line going all the ways around. Why? Is that for when you say, you know, I have had it up to here? Really, look. No, really, I have. We live in a racist world, am I right?
Right.
Am I right?
Right.
I know, because I'm Hawaiian. I'll tell you, we do. I went to a Klan meeting. Why are they still having meetings? Is there any new business with the Ku Klux Klan? What is that, for questions or something? Excuse me, Grand Wizard? Yeah. I went on vacation and I got really tanned. Should I kick my own ass and burn my house down? One time I took acid. Have you guys ever taken acid? You know what's fun to do on acid? Everything. That's the problem. We went to play miniature golf, putt-putt. Have you ever played miniature golf on acid? Oh, God. For 3 days, I thought I was the king of that little town. I was like, hello. Hello, putt-putt people. You in the windmill. Why do you hate me? Thank you very much, Winchester. Hey, if you want it to be funny every time, get Carrot Top. How's it going? We got no time to chit-chat. I'm late for a date with a beautiful girl who lives by the sea with a bad case of crabs. Her name's Baltimore. Come on!
$3?
You know, Baltimore's kind of like a closed little city, you know, has its own secrets, but, you know, I've been doing this for a while. I think I have my own way to get people to open it up. What's happening, man? Hi, I'm Dave.
Toby.
Are you guys from Baltimore?
Mm-hmm.
How is it living down here? What do you guys do for a living?
Nothing.
Are you cops? Because you kind of look like cops.
No.
You kind of look like undercover cops. Because I got a half a pound of weed on me.
I'm a cop.
Oh. That was quick. You know, they call Baltimore Charm City. Well, I'll be the judge of that. Here at the Bo Hager's Miss August contest, the sleaziest girl wins. Oh, it's a dream come true. They give you some beads to throw around, so. There you go, you bead whores. What won't people do for beads? Back to what this contest is really about. Just skanky bitches who are drunk. Now we're down to the finals. We've cut away all the fat and we're just down to pure steak.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for contestant number one.
She was cheating.
Bro, she was just showing her boobies.
War for love, contestant number two.
Yeah! That's my wife! Honey!
Contestant number three. Contestant number three.
Hey, what about me? I voted for her.
Next Friday night, we're giving away $500.
Can I borrow some money?
Here I am with Miss August. Now she's getting a little more friendly, showing us some of the talent she used to win the competition. This would never happen if I wasn't on TV. Am I right?
Absolutely.
There you go. You would, Dave Attell.
Dave?
Yeah.
Dave.
Now, what was your strategy up there? Because I saw there was a lot of girls up there, but you seemed to stand out every time.
I probably enjoyed it more than anyone. I haven't been out in like a year.
You haven't?
I have a new baby.
Oh, okay. I was thinking prison.
This is baby clothes and all the luxuries of having a baby and a new husband.
Translation, tequila shots.
You got it.
I can't drink them anymore.
Lemon twist.
Carrie, you are a lot like August. You were a good choice because you're hot, you're sticky,
hot.
You're something with deer ticks.
Yeah.
This is going to go right up on my wall and then on my floor when I'm on the toilet. Looking at it, you know what I'm saying? Really? Now, let's try and hook up with the losers. And if that doesn't work, we got a whole town to see. So come on. You know, I have to say, Brian, you really no help. I mean, I had three girls there. Where were you, you know? You could have said, no, I mean, what's that? I mean, you could have helped me out a little bit, you know? Filled me up a little bit. Hey, you know, I'm just kidding around. Thanks, guys. All right, take it easy. You're a beautiful woman, you know that, right?
Oh, thank you.
And this young man, he still looks like a good guy, right?
This is my model.
Pop my head up.
Okay, but he takes you out. This way he takes you just for a slice of pizza.
Yeah, that's all.
You gotta check her out.
This is Baltimore, man. He's real cheap.
Like, do that on tape, man.
Everybody's all riled up, man. This is not really my kind of scene. This is more like that Wild on E, you know, pair from Splash. See? Look at these young kids. Can you believe this? Look, they're just yelling to the camera for nothing at all. Look, they're yelling cymbals and all that kind of stuff. Does anybody have anything to do that? Whatever happened to the classics, you know, like Hemingway or Shakespeare?
Wait a minute, you're a bit of a St. Elmo's fire with the ripped t-shirt.
Tell Miss Socks, no, that's one thing we can't do.
A man who's more than
isn't
Miss
it?
Socks has got too much time on his hands.
No, listen to me, learn from me. You're going to be walking around, no socks, no socks. You're going to be dreaming of those socks. You'll be sitting in the corner somewhere covered in bug bites going, oh, those socks were so comfortable. Oh, I'll you off, rich guy, for a pair of socks. Come on over here, man, finally. An older fella who knows what's going on.
Hey,
okay.
In the corner.
Let me introduce you around. We got a guy who didn't make NSYNC over here, of course. And then the coolest Amish dude showed up.
Oh, my God.
And then you know, it's with the young white boys nowadays, am I right?
I mean, they try to do their thing, and hey, you can't knock them for that, because you know what?
Listen to the man!
The world changes every day. Hey, only way to do is trust in God, and guess what? Hey, but know what? When he do things for you, it might be small, but guess what? It's happening. Because every day you turn around,
and I hear that. I hear that. You're gonna get super up.
My baby girl.
Oh, she's a beauty.
Isn't she?
You girls are hot. How come you weren't at the Miss August contest?
I was already Miss June.
What? Well, thanks a lot. That's something you don't see on. Oh wait, you do see it a lot. So let's keep moving. How about something for the ladies?
Basically, when I walk in the door, it's like you don't know what's inside that door. But you're by yourself, so I just try and keep my cool.
I know what you're thinking, another cop ride-along. Well, think again. This man is not a cop. He's a male stripper, and his name's Bill Young. Am I right, Bill?
Yeah, that's me.
Now, do you mind if I call you stripper or exotic dancer, peeler? What do you prefer?
Dancer's fine.
Did you study dance, you know, tap, ballet, that river dance kind of bull? No?
No, nothing like that.
Hi, it's Austin.
Boys.
And it's a bachelor party. All right, Austin.
Now, where are we headed? Are we heading to a place where you're going to dance?
Yeah, it's a bachelor party until someone's getting married.
What other kind of outfits do you have?
Fireman's pretty popular. Doctor. There's a lot of doctors and a lot of nurses and stuff like that. Pizza guy's very popular,
really?
Too.
Really? Pizza guy? Well, that's an actual job I've had. Pretty good. What would be, like, your most memorable person you've ever danced for?
I did an 84th birthday party one time. It kind of scared me a little bit because...
Wait, you danced for an 84-year-old woman?
Yes, you get them from 18 to 80.
And what happened? I mean...
Dancing for her, and she just was so excited that she asked me to step away, and she had to get her oxygen.
She had an oxygen tank?
And I felt so bad. They're like, you almost gave me a heart attack. And, you know, they say that, but she meant it.
There they are. Whoa.
I'm
sorry,
excited.
Party time.
Turn back your waiting inside for us. Hello, ladies.
As you can tell from this poster, these girls are expecting the real deal. That's some pansy-ass shit. They want meat. Phil's laying down the law, if you know what I mean. That's how she got married in the first place. Oh, man, he can change my life bulb anytime. Look at that. Whoa! Did that come out of him? Oh, he's holding it! Gotta learn sometimes. Hey, Mom.
Hi.
How are you? Did you get a dance? I didn't see you getting a dance.
No? No, I'm just watching.
Mm. There you go. Cheaper that way. You got the tip.
Mm-hmm.
You want to dance for me?
No.
Okay, well, there you go. I thought maybe, you know, you're more mature. You could see the interview.
Well, Bill's out there cutting a rug. I got a hell of a buffet here.
Look, these girls know how to party. They got chips, champagne, always a beefcake thing going there.
Oh, man. I can do that. No, I can't. Whoa.
Ta-da. All right, ladies, be good.
Bye.
Congratulations.
Bye.
I'm coming back for your mother. I'll tell you, that is, you put on quite a show, and can you tell, like, anything on the marriage? Like, can you tell by
no idea, but hopefully people keep divorcing so I can keep doing sugar.
Keep it going. And see board. It's written that way. And these guys are up all night keeping it safe. The U.S. Coast Guard. We're on patrol. Keep your eyes open. The engine's working okay. This is a plastic float. You fall in, they throw it out to you. I got something like it at home, but it's got arms, legs, and hair. Different kind of rescue.
Now, Jane, if I hit a buoy, what happens? Do I have to pay for that? Is it like a car thing?
Oh, I'd be in a lot of trouble.
You'd be in a lot of trouble. Well, don't worry, I got insurance.
What are the key things that we're looking for?
A lot of boaters coming out of the Inner Harbor, boozing. And checking, make sure they're safe.
Well, you know, I've had a couple of drinks.
You did?
Yeah.
Attention, people of Baltimore. Hey, you. That's the old man in the boat with a young girl. Attention, everyone. I think I guess.
Until I tell you to stop.
I'm not kidding around. Don't smoke.
I'm not reading anything.
I'm not reading anything? Well, then I got some more drinking to do.
Okay, you got your job to do. I got mine to do. I'll see ya. I'm keeping the life vest. Martini is kind of like alcohol and then a little bit of a salad. But those olives, here's to you, man. There's nothing better than lighting a woman's cigar.
Watch out, Monica.
Mmm, look at that, how sexy that is. See, with a martini, you might have to try and find a spy somewhere in Thailand. You know, like James Bond.
I'm in Thailand. It used to have tassels on it, but I wore them on my nipples.
Too much information. So what is a girl's night out? It's a couple martinis, a cigar, then some yogurt, then you go home and listen to Yanni in a bubble bath. Is that what a girl's night
out is? What are you talking about?
Or is it what we all think it is? Hot, black. Now what is it? What is the secret to, like, talking to these beautiful women here? There's, like, women all around us.
I like women.
All right. What is this, Forrest Gump? Yeah, I know.
Yeah, Forrest Gump.
You girls think he's hot, don't you? Well, then, him. Don't just love him. Him. Am I right?
I agree with you.
What animal would I have sex with? Okay. I think it would be a giraffe.
Go!
I heard you. Come on, we gotta go. Full moon, deserted road, empty cornfield. That can mean only one thing. We're out with the Ghost Hunters of Baltimore International.
Ghosts? Lots of them. Very highly concentrated area of ghosts. We do have some evidence to believe that there could have been some killings here long ago.
This is our EMF detector. It comes with three lights. Mm-hmm. Safe, caution, and a danger. Right now, our safe light's kind of blinking on and off, and it should not do that. It should stay steady. Whether it's a ghost or something natural, we need to figure that out. It kept shutting off as soon as it was put on the ground. Now we're finding up here. There we go.
And that's not because of that power plant down that way?
No, we're too far away for that.
What's happening? Carl?
The ghost playing with the battery.
So they have walkie-talkies too? Are they trying to communicate?
Yeah,
let's get the hell out of here. How did you get involved in this kind of ghost hunting?
Well, I grew up in Gettysburg, so if you don't see ghosts in Gettysburg, there's something wrong with you.
Right.
I've been out here alone a couple of times. I've seen some things here before.
Like what?
See what would appear to be an apparition. Hear screams.
Now, I noticed, like, to relax people, you also do something where you hypnotize someone,
yes.
Right?
She's under post-hypnotic suggestion right now.
Mm.
Let me try. Sleep. 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 Very good, Lauren. Very good. Let's relax. Going farther and deeper into hypnosis. One, starting to wake up. Two, eyes start to open. Three, wide awake.
What happened? Do you remember anything that happened? Oh, good. Then we're safe. You were nuts. You should have seen what we made you do. How do you feel, like? Do you feel scared or...
No.
Do you want me to hug you or something? Sorry. Why, is she your girlfriend? I knew it, Jeff. The only thing worse than a ghost is a block. Am I right? Am I right? You were saying before, Jay, if you see something, you'd run it down?
Sure would.
And what would you do? Run it to the ground?
Well, that's what I'd like to do.
And then
it doesn't work,
would you?
No.
Tell me you wouldn't it and I'll call you a liar.
Wouldn't do it.
Still waiting. Still waiting.
Oh, yeah, we could be out here for hours. Hours and absolutely nothing else.
Correction, you could. I'm a busy man.
Yeah, what about your apartment? I thought that was on it.
It is. It's got the screams of a million fat girls going, call me.
What's going on?
Not sure.
It just seems like there's like a fog rolling in closer.
Jay, you're the point man, sir.
Come on over here, Lauren.
Evidently something's coming this way. Hopefully it's an ending.
Well, I thought that I saw someone moving down this area, and she thought she saw the glow of someone's eye, so...
Really? Out here? Spirit people, I'm not with these freaks. I wouldn't be out here if it wasn't for the TV show. I don't care if you crush them and turn them upside down and pull out their hearts out of their asses. But leave me alive to tell the story. Well, wait for me. All right, guys. Take it easy.
Have a good one, Dad.
Bye.
Good luck. Hope he makes it home.
Mommy. So, Pat, are you here alone?
Yeah, well, Bob, my son has karaoke.
Oh, he does. I'm sorry to hear that. You know what that is, that karaoke, Pat?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't go for that.
Well, he's a karaoke king. He's been in the Sun Papers twice.
Oh, yes. What's his name?
Charles McElhose.
We'll have to look out for him.
But he's... Karaoke Charlie is his title.
Karaoke Charlie?
Right.
Hmm. I think I've met him over the internet. Ooh, a limo, that always means a good time. Why are you guys partying?
Because it's my 21st birthday.
Your 25th, what?
My 21st birthday.
Your 21st birthday. Well, you can drink now.
Yes, I can.
Is it like Cheers where everybody knows your
name?
Or?
No. You're going to hook up with me.
Oh, I am? If
yeah.
You really don't.
No.
I guess I am.
What?
Kelly, you can't fall in love with me, Kelly. You can't. Because I'm just here for tonight. You got to meet a local boy. A guy will take you out to like a crab shack or maybe on a water taxi. You don't want a fancy pants like myself. I would just f*** you and leave.
Wow.
I mean, really. Have the best birthday possible. And if you throw up, roll over. Roll over. I got one last thing I got to do. Edgar Allan Poe. To you, he's some guy you had to read in high school and then reread in summer school. But to me, he's more of a soulmate. Think of the similarities between our lives. I was born January 18th. He was born January 19th. We're both Capricorns. He married his 15-year-old cousin. I'm working on it. So hey, I propose a toast to my soulmate and one of the greatest writers and drunks of Baltimore, Edgar Allan Poe. Let's have a little sip of one of our favorite drinks. The fuzzy navel. Mmm. Oh, nevermore. Sunrise over the USS Constellation. Time for me to go. Baltimore, thanks for having me. I'd love to stay, but as you can tell, my ride's here.
As always, I got my pictures. So I'll see you next week. Now get some sleep. Ah, I feel so fresh and confident. This is like a tampon commercial. Life is exciting as we think.